The UK has been inundated with courier-themed credential phishing campaigns throughout the past year. The Royal Mail-themed phishing scams were the first iteration of these campaigns to get public attention. However, as attention of these scams grew, so did the demand in the underworld from threat actors. However, as defenders, more campaigns gave us more intelligence. In this video, we will walk through this intelligence, giving you a brand new view of the threats facing the UK. The Royal Mail scams are still ongoing, allowing us to put these skills into practice right now. We have a number of Royal Mail branded phishing kits which we will walk through, investigate and attribute in this video. We will build up our own tracking facility to allow us to rapidly attribute future campaigns based on our knowledge learnt in this video. But how did people fall for these scam pages and how did I find them? Well, these scams were sent to victims over SMS text messaging. SMS phishing is a huge topic which we will cover in another video, but for now we can review some of the common campaigns which were sent over the last few months. We can see the lure texts remain fairly constant, requesting a user needs to pay a cost due to a package issue. Notice most of these SMS come from standard UK mobile numbers. However, we did see some SMS being sent from branded sender IDs such as these ones. So let's get started with some phishing kit analysis. Here we have a phishing kit for Royal Mail, which is titled Royal Mail UK 2020 AK Busy. When we open this, we see we have a number of PHP files. We'll work through these in a minute, but firstly, let's look at the directories and what they each contain. Within the assets directory, we have a number of static files, CSS, fonts, images, etc. Interestingly, we have a logs file, so we can open that up, and we have a blank PHP file. I can tell it's blank by looking at the size in bytes, and it's a zero, but it makes us assert that we have a potential logs directory. Moving back, we have another PHP script, so let's open that up and see what that contains. And inside we can see we have what appears to be encoded text, but we can look under the title here, blocked words. So we're going to assume that these are a list of potentially bad words which the threat actors are trying to block. We also have banned IPs, so we have a list here of IP addresses. I think it's encoded in hex. Scrolling further down, we've got more banned IP addresses, some more blocked words. We've seen this file before. This is a known file that threat actors try and use to prevent abuse of their phishing sites. So we can close this up now and we can continue exploring this phishing kit. Here we've also got a logs directory. Note the spelling with a Z. Again, a blank PHP file. So now we have two logs directories within assets and within this home directory. Monica is just an index file which we can open up very quickly. And in here we see that it includes a config file. It includes a functions in our assets directory, which we can take a look at in a minute. It also contains a date format, as well as some other information such as IP address, host name, user agent, and then it all writes this out into a bot variable. Moving back into the kit, we'll start looking at index.php. When you load a website, you will always land on index.php. So we're just trying now to work out and understand where the user will get redirected. We can see we have a threat actor alias right at the top of the file here, at Kr3pto. Kr3pto is a known threat actor targeting the UK with a number of phishing kits. There's a huge amount of intelligence online related to this actor. We have a number of includes at the top, such as a config file, again our functions file which we've seen before, and a number of other IP and visitor log checks. What's most interesting to us is this header location. So this is a redirect which is put in place. We can see here that it redirects to express.php. It then has a fake PHP parameter of SSL equals true and a fake session parameter, which is just a random generated string of 130 characters. So our next step now is to go and look at this express.php file to try and understand what's happening within this kit. We can open that up here, express.php. Again, we have our includes at the top, which we expect. And now we start looking through. Here we see the HTML contained within the phishing kit. We can see the title of the page is Royal Mail, as we suspected. We've got a number of style sheets and JavaScript sheets. We've got a date of birth mask here. When we do phishing kit analysis, it's not important to understand and know every single line. What we need to do, because we have so many files, we need to learn very quickly what is and isn't important for us to look at. Scrolling through here very quickly, I'm seeing that we have a number of just links. So this is just building up the web page with a number of links. Interestingly, still to the legitimate Royal Mail. So it's just giving the site a look of legitimacy. What we are interested in is some of these other pages. So we appreciate that the landing page is going to be called express.php. We get the redirect from index.php. Within express.php, it will redirect to any one of these pages. If we now have a look at loading.php, this is where we can actually see the exfiltration data being sent. We can see the information which is stolen from a user, and we can see where it's being sent to. So here is all the information that's being stored within the session, and it's being written to variable names. These variable names are then enriched with some further functions. We can have a look at these in a second. It's building up our victim info, which they've nicely called it. Here we have the subject line of the email. So it's branded as Kr3pto Royal Mail, and then the user's bin number, the type, the brand, the bank, the country. And here we see the actual output log, which will be emailed and also stored on the compromised host or the stood up infrastructure. We have the full name, date of birth, email address, telephone address, town and postcode. We have all the card information, and we also have when it was received and all the victim information based on their IP address. Moving further down, we can see that we have a mail script. So this emails out the user's information. If there is a variable set to true or one, it will then save this information within royalmaillogs.txt. It writes this data and then closes the file. Very interesting, we have a one-time access. So if a user has accessed the site again, their IP address gets added to this blacklist.dat, and it will then close the user out if it sees the same IP address again. Let's now take a look at config.php. So here is our config.php file. These are really interesting to look at. We can see at the top we have this threat actor's name again. We also have a generic email address, which the threat actor, once deployed, will then change that email address to receive information. Below that, we have our saved on host options, which we can change to 0 or 1, depending on how a threat actor wishes to deploy this. Below that, we have our one-time access. Notice our text on top, which is going to be our brander image, as we can see in some images of this deployed kit at the moment, is we can actually change what this says on the website. This allows threat actors to customize their pages. Below that, we see parcel tracking, again, a fake parcel tracking name. And further down, we have the exit link. Notice that it's utilizing a Google redirect to actually redirect a user through a Google search engine into the royalmail.com. So what can we do with this information? Well, what we need to start doing now is building up a information sheet to utilize this in the future. I like to do this using very simple tools such as LibreOffice or Excel. So what we like to do at the top is we like to have a kit name, a kit hash, the landing page, and any notes. So what we can do is we can take the kit name, which we know we've already got. Next, we need the kit hash. This can be very simply generated utilizing the command line SHA-256 sum, and then typing in our kit name. hitting enter, and we have now the SHA-256, which we can copy and paste into our information. Next, we need to type in the landing page. The reason this is important is so we can attribute this kit based on very minimal amounts of information. As we previously saw, the landing page was express.php. But we can take this one step further. Let's remind us of what the kit looked like. Here we have the index.php, and we can see at the bottom it loads express.php and then it adds a number of PHP parameters. Let's take these PHP parameters as well as the generate random string feature, and this way we can link this kit in the future if we see it again. So we can put this into here, and now we've got all the information we require to build up intelligence on this phishing kit. If we had any notes, we could add them here. The note that I would like to add, let's look at our kit again, is our threat actor signature at the top here. So we can add into the notes that we know that that is a threat actor's name. And what we are doing here is we're building up an intelligence picture on these Royal Mail phishing scams. Now this is just one kit of many, so let's work through some more and we'll see how we get on. Here we have another phishing kit. This one is entitled royalmail.zip. It looks very different from our previous kit which we looked at. There's a number of files just within this home directory. We can see we've got some WOOF files, some font files in there, some SVG, so image files, etc. At the top we have assets, logs, and a couple of results. These are zero in size, but we do now know our victim location within assets, logs, results if we need to use this. When we move back, we look inside files. We have image files and we have some JavaScript files as well. Within our includes, we've got myemail.php and userinfo.php. Within myemail.php, we can see that a threat actor should enter their email here. We also have a from address, so if you wish to change that, send logs, save logs, one-time access, as well as encryption. You can see that this config file looks very similar to the previous kit which we looked at, and this is very common. We see a lot of threat actors stealing, copying and utilizing code from other kits. If we have a look at userinfo.php, within here, we've got a number of functions such as get operating system, and we can see here that it pulls either unknown, or if it finds in the user agent, it will then write down a clean view of what that user agent could mean. We've also got get browser, so a threat actor knows which browser a user is utilizing. And that is all that's in that file. Moving back to the kit now, we can move up the directory. We can see all these files down here. There's a huge number of files. Now remember, the thing that we're most interested about is the landing page. Where does a user go when they first hit this? It will always be index.php. So let's open this up and let's try and start working out what's going on here. We're gathering some IP information from the user, and we're hashing this in an MD5 algorithm, so not the most secure. I'm not sure why they're using this, but I'm sure we'll discover why they're doing this in a minute. They're also then creating a session for the user. Here they create a visitor log. Within the visitor log, they write the originating IP address, the date, and that is all that seems to be added. They then close this file. And here we have our header location redirect. We're redirecting users to user.php along with a session ID, which is the MD5 of the IP address as seen up here, as well as another secure SSL equals true. Again, all fake PHP parameters. So we now know that a user will first load up this website and get redirected to user.php. Now let's try and find the exfiltration script used in this kit. And here we have it. It's called complete.php. And at the top we see it's again gathering the user's IP address, hashing it through the MD5 algorithm. As we scroll down, we can see there's a number of items which I think they're error handling in case the item that has been empty Moving along, we got some includes, which includes the user info and myemail.php, which we know has the threat actor's email address in it. Again, we see here at to your email, this your email comes from this PHP script, so this is the sending. We can see now we're building up a message. Again, we've got a threat actor's signature at the top, so we're going to copy this as we're going to utilize that in a minute. And then it's pulling out information that the user's entered: full name, date of birth, address, city, country, postcode, memorable name, phone number, the card information, as well as IP address. Down here, we've got our save logs, so where they get written to, and we have the send log as well. And then we have a final redirect at the bottom here to redirect.php. What we need to do now is update our tracking sheet with this new kit which we have discovered. In our notes, we can put our threat actor signature, which we have just discovered. Let's go back now to the index page to find out our landing page information. And we can see within index.php at the top here, our redirect. So let's take all of this string and we can paste this into here. We generate the kit hash exactly the same way as we generated the other kit hash, SHA-256-SUM, and typing in the name of the kit. Hitting enter, and there we have our kit hash. We can utilize this to fingerprint the kit, and then the kit name, which we can copy and paste like so. And now we're building up a tracking sheet which allows us to attribute campaigns in the future. Let's keep going. Here is our new phishing kit which we are investigating. We open it up and we see we have assets and logs. I hope now you're starting to appreciate how many of these kits contain duplicate items from other kits based on the same theme. We can see we have a number of different naming conventions here: address, ante, book, complete, config, date settings, finish, index, payment, and robots. So using our previous method, let's have a look at index.php. Within index.php, we have a number of include functions. We have a random generation string. We have a random tracking number, or if it comes with a tracking number, so if a PHP parameter is already set, it will use that. Otherwise, it would default to this string here. And we can see we get a instant redirect to book.php. Let's have a look at book.php. And here we have book.php. Again, all of our imports are coming in. We've also got a redirect once everything is completed to complete.php. And we've now got the HTML elements of this phishing site. So the title is Redelivery, arrange online for the Royal Mail Group LTD. As we can see, this is clearly a phishing site. So now we know where the user is sent to complete.php. Let's take a look at that file within our kit here, complete.php. And we can see we've already got an exfiltration script ready. We can see that it takes a large amount of information which is set, writes it to variables, it grabs some other information, enriches it with date and time stamps, it grabs the numbers from cards, etc. Victim information, I hope this is starting to look familiar to you, this victim info. Scrolling down now to our actual data field or message, if you like, we have a threat actor attribution at the top. We have some billing information, card information, and victim information. Again, we have a threat actor signature at the bottom, spam it up. And we have some save on host items set, logs, royalmailuk.txt. And we also have some visitor and bin information stored as well. Let's now take a look at config.php. Within config.php, we have a email address, so this threat actor seems to have kept their email address in. We have a save on host as well, so we can turn on and off log files, and we have an exit link. So now we can go and update our tracking sheet with this new information. Working from the back, we have our notes where we have the threat actor signature. The landing page we can copy and paste from the index.php, just like so. We generate the kit hash just like we did previously, and there is our hash. And then we can just paste in the kit name which we've attributed. So now we're starting to build up a really good picture. We have three kits fingerprinted and identified. We have a number of overlaps between all these. Not only do we have all the victim information looking very similar, we have very similar PHP coding, all with config files, but notice all the landing pages are different. So now what we can do some research, and when we find other campaigns utilizing express.php, user.php, book.php, we can attribute these back to some linked known threat actor names.